We're now ready to talk about Camber-Line design. And so let's start back with our relationship that we got from thin airfoil theory. And the fundamental equation for thin airfoil theory can be written like this. Okay, so this was the fundamental equation from thin airfoil theory, and notice this is the small angle approximation. We're using an alpha there instead of a sine alpha. And I'll just write that here. That's a small angle approximation. And one thing, so what we did with thin airfoil theory originally in previous videos is we treated the camber line as the known, and we solved for the gamma distribution, gamma of x naught. But this is just this equation, if it's satisfied, will hold for a thin airfoil with small camber. You know, there are other approximations that went into this, potential flow and small camber. But instead of another way to look at this is to instead of treating the camber line as the known and the distribution of gamma as the known, we can actually treat the distribution of, the distribution of gamma as the unknown. Then we can actually switch that and treat the gamma as the known and solve for a camber line that will give us a specific lift distribution. So let's just talk about why that works here. That works because our lift is related to the gamma distribution. So the total lift on the airfoil is rho v infinity times capital gamma. And capital gamma is just the integral of little gamma. And little gamma can be thought of as the chordwise, or is related to the chordwise distribution of lift. And so if you, the chordwise distribution of lift you could write that as a gamma, well, rho v infinity times gamma of x naught. So that, so the chordwise distribution at some x naught value could be written like this. And so we're simply integrating that over the entire airfoil in order to get the total lift over here. And the reason that works is because if we look back at a vortex sheet, remember that there's a discontinuity in tangent velocity, but not in normal velocity on the surface of the sheet. So on the upper surface, for example, we'll have a velocity going this direction, and on the lower surface, we'll have a velocity going that direction. And there's a discontinuity in that, or a step change in velocity as we cross that camber line sheet. But the normal velocity is the same. And so we can compute essentially what we're doing by using a camber line sheet here, or a vortex sheet along the camber line, is that we're giving a step change in pressure, and the step change in pressure is directly proportional or related to the strength of the sheet at any location. Okay, so if we look at an airfoil, here's an airfoil, and I could plot above this the pressure on that airfoil for the upper and the lower surfaces. And usually we plot the pressure in the negative direction. So we have actually I can leave this as a positive, but we do like negative numbers up here So like negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. We usually flip the y-axis of that because on our upper surface is where we have our lower pressures. And by flipping it, we end up having the upper surface pressure will be at the top, usually at a positive angle of attack, and then the lower surface pressure will be below that if we flip the pressure, because it's the higher pressure. So anyway, I've drawn a really poor pressure distribution here, but essentially what this camber line here is defining is the difference in pressure between the top and the bottom surface. So we could look at this delta here between the two. The strength of the camber line at any point is basically telling us the delta between the upper surface and the lower surface. And that's because it's creating a step change in tangential velocity, and therefore a step change in pressure. So all this being said, we can relate a gamma of X naught to our desired pressure. If we have a desired pressure distribution or delta pressure distribution across the airfoil, you know, delta between the top and the bottom, then we can relate that to gamma, and that is related to our lift distribution over here, chordwise lift distribution. That depends on gamma, on this little gamma. And so if we know what that is, we can plug that into this equation as the known, and we can solve for the camber line. So we'll work through an example in the next video of how to do that for one example pressure distribution.